Hey everyone, and once again welcome to WS Cube Tech YouTube channel. Myself Umar Taskeer. Guys, in this particular video I am going to talk about different kind of backlinks which we have to avoid actually, right? So backlink is a topic which always comes with a lot of confusion. So in this specific video, what we are going to discuss is what kind of backlinks we should avoid, what kind of backlinks we should not look for the purpose of increasing the ranking of our website, right? So let's begin. And what I have mentioned over here is five kinds of backlinks that we have to avoid, or five kind of strategies also we can say that we should not work on during our search engine optimization. So the first strategy or the first type of backlink is spammy link or comments of others' blog or website. What we have seen is people are going to different websites, no matter what kind of relevancy they have with your website, they just go there, they just drop their website link over there for the purpose of creating backlink, which is again not a very great practice. You have to look after so many factors, and you have to see that whether that content on which you are putting your backlink, that website, that web page on which you are putting your backlink is actually related with your website or not. So these kind of factors are there. You should consider those factors first, or you should look after those factors first, and then you should go for creating backlinks. Most of the time people end up creating n number of backlinks, or they just focus on creating or increasing their number of backlinks, which is not a great practice. What comes here is not quantity, or what works here is actually not quantity, it is quality. Now Google does not focus on quantity of backlinks. Earlier talking about like 2009-10, it was there when Google's algorithm was not that smart, it was not that accurate, perfect from backlinks point of view. So at that particular time it was obvious that if you were creating higher number of backlinks, there were chances that your website will end up ranking high in the search engine result pages. But now it is not going to work, right? You have to make sure that your backlinks are quality. And what actually defines the quality? When we say we should produce quality backlinks is basically relevant backlinks, right? If you are getting backlinks from a relevant website in terms of content, if you are getting backlink from a trusted website in terms of content, then the backlink is considered to be a quality backlink. So that's it. So we should not focus on the number of the backlinks, right? That if I'm getting 10 backlinks or my competitor is getting 20 backlinks, so I should aim for 20 backlinks. No, you can still rank higher with those 10 backlinks which are there with you, right? The main point or the important thing over here is the quality. If the quality of your backlink is greater, right, greater or superior than your competitor's backlink, definitely you're gonna rank. So there are different parameters also which are like domain authority or the page authority, which are given by analyzing the backlink profile of your domain, right, or the web page by different tools. There is then RF, there is then Moz. They do have different parameters on which they actually analyze what kind of domain value or what kind of page value you are having, and the main foundation of that analysis is basically backlink. So they consider backlinks, right, the quality of your backlinks, and then they associate that value with domain rating, domain ranking, or page rating or page ranking, right? So if you want to increase your page ranking or page ratings, what you have to do is generally you have to focus on your backlinks, right? So backlink is that indicator which actually reflects, right? It actually reflects into your domain rating and page rating, right? So this is the first thing that I discussed with you, spammy links in the form of comments of other blogs or the website. We should avoid it, right? We can go for some relevant blog commenting, but we should not go for spammy links, right? Then non-relevant link exchange, right? So as I told you, link exchange is not a great thing to do in search engine optimization, or when we are looking for creating backlinks, right? So we should not opt for like exchange of links, right? So if my website is giving a link to your website, or your website is giving to a link to mine, one is basically a link exchange, which is not a great practice in terms of Google system, right? Then there is automation kind of strategies which people do use in order to gain higher number of backlinks in shorter period of time, which is again a very bad practice and which we should avoid, right? There are many tools. If you go on internet or Google, you will be able to find tools like Scrapbox, Zoomer, which basically are automation tools, and they can create thousands and lakhs of backlinks within a day, right? So if you are creating that number of backlinks within a day, within a week or 2 days or 3 days, in a very short span of time, it is not actually going to work. Google will identify that you are doing something mischief, right? And which is not a great practice. You are opting some black hat SEO strategy, or you are going for some tool, automation tool, and your link building strategy or approach is actually not natural, which is not a great thing, right? Whatever the links you are putting, or whatever the links you are backlinks actually you are creating, should be natural. They should look natural. I mean, you are creating those backlinks, so those are not natural, obviously, but still they should look, because the backlinks are natural or they are not natural is actually determined the Google algorithm. So those should look natural to Google system or Google algorithm. So if you are creating thousands and lakhs of backlinks within a very short span of time, that will not be considered as natural backlink in terms of Google. Then if we talk about buying links from Fiverr, then there are many services on different marketplaces like Freelancer, Fiverr, where you can buy links. There are people who are selling links, so we should not buy those links, because again those links are majorly made from the automation tools, because they promise you giving thousands and thousands of backlinks within 1 or 2 or 3 days, which is not going to work, and Google will be able to identify very easily that you have opted for some automation tool or something like that, and your backlinks are not natural, relevant, and you paid, or there's something like that, right? So Google will identify that, and your search engine result page rankings will go down, or it will not provide you any value, and in some of the cases Google also penalize you. So you have to make sure that you are not using all these things, all these kind of backlinks, right? Then there is a link velocity. We have to find the optimal link velocity. We should not create many backlinks within a short span of time. This is again an indication to Google that something wrong is happening over there, because naturally you cannot create thousands and thousands of backlinks in a day. So if this kind of activity is happening over there, right, if the link velocity is very high, or it is in positive, right, and way positive, then you should consider it. It is again a very important thing. So we should not go for creating thousands of backlinks in a very short span of time. Google will figure it out that we are doing something wrong, right? So that's it for this specific video. See you in the next video. Till then, goodbye.